When you look at this worksheet and these numbers, do you see anything wrong? This is a worksheet in Google Sheet, and this is a list of the largest companies, and it's sorted by market cap in millions. And so I'm scrolling down, and the companies are becoming smaller. But do you see that? Does it feel like the companies are becoming smaller? Not necessarily. Look at this. For example, this number is for a company that is smaller than the one above it. But it doesn't appear that way. Why? Because this number is taking more space than the one above. And you can see it all over the place. The number should be taking less space the more down we go because the numbers are smaller. But sometimes they appear larger and then they become smaller and then become larger again. And look at the decimal places. Some of the decimal places with numbers such as ones are taking less space than some with like eights and nines. And you can see the decimal place, it becomes like a zigzag. You're not having them aligned, so it's hard to read the information. It's skewing the information, so it becomes distorted. And if I show you the same numbers right here, look at that, how different they look. You can see that the numbers are becoming smaller. Everything is aligned. All the decimal places are aligned. And the market cap is decreasing. And so you will see that the numbers will be taking less space. There is no zigzag alignment as in here. And what's the difference? The only difference is a choice of fonts. And so this is one thing that sometimes we don't discuss. Our choice of font for Google Sheet or Excel, it really matters. This font is one of the more popular fonts. And there's many popular fonts that I personally even liked as well, but I'm trying to stay away from because of this distortion and the way they align numbers. And there's some great alternatives that are just as beautiful, but they're very clear to read. They don't skew information. Everything aligns correctly. The space for each of the numbers the same. And they're also beautiful for text and headings as well. So we will go over some of the fonts that maybe you should consider staying away from and some of the great alternatives for Google Sheets or Excel. So I have a Google Sheet set up here and I have at the top list of fonts and some of them are very popular. Oswald, Georgia, Montserrat. Like Montserrat is one of my favorite fonts because it's very clear, readable, but I'll show you that it has some issues and I actually been trying to stay away from it when I'm using Google Sheet or Excel because of the how it skews the numbers. And then we have Laura, Playfair, Display, and a few others. And I'll show you what the issue is. And then below, I have a list of other great alternative fonts, and some of them are called monospaced fonts. So a monospaced font is a font that has the same amount of space for each of the characters or numbers. And some of them might not be monospaced, like they're not called monospaced like Claro and Unido. However, when you see the numbers and how they align, they look very much so. So I have numbers in all the digits, starting with 111,111 until we get to 999,999. And I'm going to copy these numbers and I'm going to paste it over for each of the formats. Now I'm not going to do Command V because I would be pasting over formatting. So I actually have to go to Edit, Paste Special, Values Only, because I have all the formats already set up and you can see right away where the issue lays. So we have like font like Oswald, you can see that ones and seven are much more narrow versus the numbers that are like eights and nines. And it's the same true for many numbers. Georgia, another very popular font, you can see the sevens and ones are much smaller, much more narrow versus sixes and eights. Montserrat, this is my favorite. And look at the ones, they look so tiny compared to like the nines and eights and even fours. So you can see how they can be skewing information and misleading. When you have a number with all fours that looks larger than with all sevens, that's a problem. The same with Laura, especially the ones are very small, or Playfair Display. It's another very great font for headings, text, and so on, but you can see how each of these numbers, they're all over the place, spacing-wise, the fives and threes even, they just take different amount of space, so you can mislead with your analysis when you're presenting the numbers, it can look very skewed. And the same with pop-ins. And then ultra, it has even other issues like being so bold. I'm not even using a variation of a bold for the font. And it's just after a while, if you're looking at any kind of analysis with these numbers, you would just get a headache because it's overwhelming. It's hard to read, not very readable. So the alternative is a list of these fonts below. And I'm going to paste these numbers here as well, so you can see right away how great they look. And I'm going to also do edit, paste special, values only, because I don't want to paste any formatting. And right away you can see how well they look. They're great because they're aligned across from the small numbers to the big numbers. They all take the same amount of space, even though Latin and Unita are not really monospace fonts. They're very much in the same category as monospace fonts because you can see how well the numbers align. And even though, you know, some of these like are monospace, let's say Courier New and Roboto, and they might look very cold, computer-like, kind of like typewriter-like, and I don't like using them. There are many good alternatives. Like my favorite right now is Nunito because it looks great as text. It's very readable. The titles, headings look great. And the same with Latto. But they don't have the alignment, the misleading, skewing issue that some of these other fonts have. So they're really great alternative. And obviously you could have a combination of using text and titles with some of these fonts, and then combine with the fonts that are more monospaced for the numbers. However, that's kind of tricky and hard to remember where you have which kind of font, and it's not going to be consistent, and it can lead to a lot of issues and a lot of extra work. So I prefer using the same font for the entire Google Sheet. That's why I go with like Nunito, Latto, or even Open Sans. It's really another beautiful font that doesn't have the issue of being of skewing numbers, and it's really great for headings and titles. And some of the less known are here listed as well. And I'll show you how you can get more fonts in Google Sheets in another video. I will have a list of the ones that I recommend so you can have a look and try them. So thanks so much for watching.